Alrighty guys, it is Kwaman here today, also known as Detective Hugh, and after watching Dragon Ball Super episode 109 and 110, I wanted us to have a discussion in regards to Jiren as a hero versus a villain in the series, because quite honestly, after watching all of the feats that Goku was throwing against Jiren and going Ultra Instinct, Mastery of Self-Movement, and then going Super Saiyan God and throwing a Spirit Bomb, I kind of forgot that Jiren was a good guy, and I wanted to share my thoughts with you guys in this conversation today in terms of Jiren and what would it be like if he was a villain. So, the question that I want to first bring up here is actually dealing with Dispo. So, this first actually happened to me many episodes ago when I saw Hit going up against Dispo in the Tournament of Power, and the way that Dispo was talking down to Hit and snickering at him, and the fact that, you know, Dispo was just being so difficult for Hit to actually fight against, especially in the earlier stages, I kind of forgot that he was supposed to be a good guy. And the same thing happened to all of the other Pride Troopers when they were fighting against Khalifa and Kale. And I think that's actually something very good that Dragon Ball Super has done, because they've kind of rewarped our minds into looking at good versus evil and just looking at all of the members in the Tournament of Power as just opponents. For example, Frieza and Frost are villains, but yet we've kind of just looked at them and have assimilated them as just other fighters in the Tournament of Power. And obviously Frost has been erased now, and it's not really a spoiler because you wouldn't be watching this video if you didn't think it wasn't a spoiler. But either way guys, going back to the point here, in regards to Jiren and the Pride Troopers, it made me wonder, are they this strong because Universe 11 has extremely powerful enemies that kind of always surface out of nowhere, similar to One Punch Man, in which all of these random villains just randomly pop up and start wreaking havoc throughout multiple cities? Or are these guys just naturally strong? Because in theory, if Jiren was a villain, it would be virtually impossible to take him down unless all of the gods teamed up on him. Or less, what if the Gods of Destruction managed to take him out through some other means, looking at how powerful he was going up against an Ultra Instinct Goku? And to me, it kind of says, does these Pride Troopers in their respective universe have an easy picking with their daily routines of just wiping out villains one by one? Because in reality, if these guys are naturally this powerful, it would be hard for me to believe that anybody would ever be able to cause crime throughout their respective universe, and they must be going up through some serious competition for all of them to be this strong. And in regards to the weaker members of the Pride Troopers, and I think I really have to mention them here guys, the most interesting thing about all of the weaker ones is the fact that despite how much weaker they are from the big three in Dispo, Topo, Jiren, and then Casserole, even though he was eliminated with them, compared to all of the other characters that we've had in Universe 7, those weaker Pride Troop members would be almost on a god tier proportional to the weaker villains that we've had in the past. So if their B team is that powerful proportional to the previous characters, it really makes you wonder about the Pride Troopers in their own respective universe and what they go through on a daily basis. And this brings me into my next conversation here, guys. In terms of the Pride Troopers, would you guys want to actually see a Pride Trooper special or a Pride Trooper storyline in which we go to Universe 11 and kind of see what these guys do in their relative life? Because if these guys are really protecting the universe, it really makes you wonder how everything is organized and how crime really works, considering that there's so many different Pride Troopers and they have recruits that train under them that get even more powerful over time. So I really think that whole superhero Tuck Sentai concept that Dragon Ball is applying to the Pride Troopers is something that's very interesting from Dragon Ball, and quite honestly, after seeing what Jiren was capable of, it really makes me wonder that they're literally like the Justice League on crack in their own respective universe. And let me know what you think in the comment section below as to the Pride Troopers, their feats, their power scaling, and everything in the comment section below. So with everything else said, please remember to rate, comment, and subscribe. And remember, as I always say, to have a great day, guys, and let me hear all of your thoughts.